Morning, Andrea. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, Massimo. Hello, everyone from Italy. Today is 11 a.m. in Italy, and probably it's, I see people from Singapore, from Japan, from Asia. Maybe it's late your time. Thank you for coming. Thank you for attending this GMI webinar. Today we are, there is Massimo Pagani and I. So let's wait another few minutes, Massimo.
Yeah, no problem.
We're connecting. People already writing something. Good evening. Good evening. Thank you. It's our, say, last webinar before our short summer holidays. Now we'll see, but see that a lot of you are still working. That's fine. Okay, maybe Massimo, we can start, and in time you can have a discussion about what we are and so on. Okay. Okay, this is dedicated for ESD fire and gas applications. Based on our experience, and we'll try to say share with you what is our opinion, how to do something, okay? And let's talk about us. So myself, Andras Polora, I'm a global account manager at GM International. I'm working since 2015. I was responsible for European market, and now I'm in charge of a major key account worldwide. And there is Massimo Pagani. Spagani is a product manager and is our manager also for customer assistance. He has a very long experience in application, the products, and also safety engineer. We conduct this presentation together with different pages, so you will see later. But first of all, you want to introduce a little bit GM International for the one of you are not aware about. Our company is we design and produce a product for physical safety application and also seal applications. For main critical application packages like DCS, different gas, IPS, PLCs. For critical also field, oil and gas, chemical, petrochemical. We have a long experience, more than 40 years. We were founded in 1993, but the former Elkon Instruments company was our company. Maybe some of you know that brand. We have a production completely in Italy. We have near Milan. But we have also global presence all over the world. About 10 offices, about 10 offices. We are opening another two in the next coming months. 75 distributors, 200 people, total staff, and also we organize different courses beside the webinars. We have different courses for functional safety, for EX, for cybersecurity. And also numbers about our installation. So what do we say that we produce completely in Italy? We have a say state-of-the-art technology, complete testing, completely automatized the production, 5 years warranty, and 10 years also guarantee spare times once the product will be in the phase out. About our certification, we have a complete certification for all major market, for European market, international market. Also, we have certification for markets such as Russia, Japan, China, India, Brazil, and also for the America, UL. So we have also safety management certification. Also, beside the product, the design certificate, the systematic capability that is necessary to get the seal certification for the product. This is the product we produce on intrinsic safe isolator or barriers, safety relays, isolator, power supply, multiplexer, termination board for main VCS producer, hard multiplex surge protection indicators, and cybersecurity. If you want to have more details about that, we can give it. Not in this webinar, of course. This is our customers divided by system vendors, EPC, OEMs, and end users. We divide this presentation. You can make a question anytime using your Q&R. The chat is disabled, so you can just make your question. We try to answer verbally or in writing during this. It's divided in chapters, so we divided it for the safety, relay concept, fire gas application, state application, mode bus interface, and conclusion. And this is the, it's your part, Massimo, I guess.
Yes, yes, thank you, Andrea. And welcome to all participants also from my side. And well, let's start examining those that are a fundamental part of ASIS. Let's talk about safety relay. A safety relay can stop or initiate a movement in a controlled safe manner by opening, closing valves, start-stop motor, and so on. And they must conform and adhere to the ESC 61508 industrial standard. Not only oil and gas or process industry, but in general, a safety relay can be used where a failure of a relay can cause serious accident to human environment assets or image. Well, but what are the typical cases where a safety relay is required? So typically we must use a safety relay in all those applications where the controller, the digital output card of a PLC, is enabled to activate a field device due to its limited potential in relation to the voltage and current involved, or in those applications where multiple contacts for the simultaneous activation of multiple loads is required. Or again, in those applications where the safety function that the controller must perform needs to be inverted. But what is the difference from standard to a safety relay? Andrea, I think this is your turn to explain this this part.
Okay, we can say, of course, in the market you can use different relays. There are standard relays and there are safety relays. Especially, we are talking about the process applications, not machine, but only process. And the difference between a standard relay and the SIL relay is that the SIL relay is a device with a non-guarantee ability to perform a given safety function. So there is a FMEDA calculation that grants that that relay, that of course apparatus, because the FMEDA can be supply from the manufacturer for different hardware, okay? But in this case, there is a specific FMEDA calculation that grants that the probability of failure is below a certain level. So we are using not components, standard components, but specific components. And for each component, there is, of course, a certain failure rate declared by the manufacturer. All the components, all the failure rates are, say, collected in one FMEDA that is because the safety relay is composed by different more than 100 components. And each of that is, of course, is calculated, and the FMEDA here is resulted by that failure rate of each specific component. So the goal for the relay is reach a specific state on demand. So for example, open relief valve or activate a fire extinguisher. Basically, when there is demand, the relay has to open the circuit or has to close circuit with very high probability. There is no possibility of the probability of failure should be really low. Higher accelerated the lower, of course, probability of failure. Applications are, for example, ESD, HIPS, BMS, where the safety function is normally energized. So when not the safety function, the function is normally energized, I want to de-energize to safety. So in this case, DTS, de-energize to safety, is the safety. So I want to disconnect my load. The other way around, in the fire and gas application, you have a normally de-energized load. You want to energize in case of safety. Here, on this drawing, you can see the simple drawing, the simple connection of two loads. One is normally energized, and one is normally energized. This is the normally energized, and this is the normally de-energized. In this case, I see that for activating normally energized, I'm using three relays connected series. Why for normally de-energized, there are three relays connected in parallel. Okay, so, but why use, in this case, we introduce a concept, the concept of a safety relay, but why you should use a smart relays? So in smart relay, there are additional capabilities, and it has to be used when only the diagnostic, the line monitoring is required. So because, why? There is a problem because safety relays, if you use a safety relays between the system and the valve, of course, the safety relays act as a wall in the, let's say, the pulse testing coming out from the DO card, from the PLC DO card, is not reaching the load. So you are not able to, let's say, detect the failure, basically, that the word for which the pass testing is designed. In this case, this pass testing dies at the relay coil and you cannot have any information about the load. Well, so, okay. Yeah.
It's my turn now.
Oh yeah. I was just saying that smart relays have this built-in diagnostic capabilities that give that possibility. So it's extending, smart relays is extending the PLC diagnostic capability.
Perfect. Thank you, Andrea. Well, let's get into what are the smart relay. The smart relay is a relay that guarantees a specific safety function, like a typical safety relay, but in addition, it has the ability to perform a complete field diagnostics. For a complete diagnostic, we mean a diagnostic that includes complete constantly monitor of line and load function in both operating condition of the relay, on and off status. In fact, the diagnostic of a smart relay is able to monitor the functional parameters of the field devices and the line, both to know in real time the health status of the loop in the condition of load energization, and as a predictive function to know whether in the event of a request for intervention, the devices in the field will activate correctly. This is a very important, especially in fire and gas safety system. We can say that smart relay combine the basic functionality of the safety relays with a complete line load diagnostic. But why going for smart relay? Nowadays, full diagnostics is typically required along the VUL loop. However, many widespread systems do not support diagnostic inside their digital output card. And the smart relay makes diagnostic available to systems that do not support it. In other case, many modern systems do support digital output diagnostic, However, in many applications, they cannot directly drive the load because they are voltage and current limited, typically no more than 500 milliamp at 24 volt DC. Or when the load bulb, beacon, sounder, and so on, require more than 24 volt and or more than 500 milliamp. Relay are necessary. And yet, when using standard relay, the digital output diagnostic, bulb testing, dies at the relay coil and cannot reach the load in the field. As opposed to that, smart relay can go beyond the typically voltage current system limitation while keeping the full load diagnostic. Even if modern systems can perform load diagnostic, their capability may be limited. For instance, air leakage monitor may not be supported, or extreme load, for example, beacons, may always be reported as an open circuit to the system. Smart relay may offer a solution to extend the digital output diagnostic capability. Two different safety functions coexist inside smart relay. The first and also the main function consists in the input to output or coil to contacts, activation, deactivation. This is the typical function of a safety relay, which upon request is able to drive a load applied to it in a safe state. The second one is the diagnostic function. It provides full measures, voltage, current, resistance, air leakage, of the load also through Modbus protocol, and it can activate, deactivate two full dry contacts. The smart relay is equipped with the fault relay, and any anomalies can be acquired through the Modbus protocol. And again, the smart relay is also available for installation in hazardous area, to be precise, zone 2, division 2. And we can also say that the main function, coil to contact, is certified seal free, while the diagnostic is certified seal 2. Well, Andrea, is your turn for a poll?
Yeah, we do have a small, short, let's say, poll, if you want to answer to these questions. Let me check for the right one. Okay, go. If you wanna answer, keep just 1 minute of this webinar. What relay type do you use on your safety application? You can use it just to cancel to one or more answer. Of course, question. You can use common relays with no safety, standard relays, standard relay with less capability. On probably the PLC that the integrated relay functionalities, there are some of them, of course, that can be used. So we have also two questions for the attendees, and then maybe we can answer just after this poll.
Yes, the first question is smart relay is
Let us the people
Okay, sorry, yes.
Answer first, but we can stop in a few seconds. I don't see further answers. Okay, we can stop now. I can also share the results with you. So most of you use standard safety relays, but also some of you safety relay diagnostic functionalities. Okay, thank you for answering. And then we have two questions that we can answer live, probably. So, Massimo, is smart relays tested with ASCO or IMI Norgren solenoid valve?
But Andrea, our smart relay are tested with different kind of devices, field devices, our beacon, sounder, and in some cases, also with the valve, EHD valve, but at this moment I don't remember if we tested our smart relay with specifically ASCO or
Yeah. Maybe we can. We have some probably some trick because we have of course configurable smart relays that we see later on this presentation, and you can give us some trick. If you wanna contact us via emails, it will be say better. But for having specific information about this kind of okay. The second question is. From the same attendees. Can smart relay be used with the 2 out of 3 Serenite valve configuration?
Well, this yes, I...
Yes.
This
yes.
is a difficult difficult question, but I think...
No, but, I don't see any...
It's necessary to see a specific application, a specific load, because sometimes the... It's difficult to match the diagnostic parameters with the, this kind of application.
Oh, yeah, because you are connecting not directly to one or more than one. Okay. Yeah. Okay, good. We answer to the open question. We can go on. And this is the, of course, what we are realizing in our relays is a unique relay matrix, which is quite interesting, especially basically all smart relays are equipped with this matrix relays. And where we have, you can see two relays in parallel and in serial to the load, and then with the other two relays. So when the coil is activating the relay for opening or closing, all the four relays will move simultaneously. So we have additional function than standard safety relay can give. For instance, you can have a unique relay for normal energized or normally de-energized load, because the safety, the C3 is reached in both cases with this kind of matrix. We have increased availability and fault tolerance. It means you see from the drawing over there, if one relay fails, the safety functions, in this case, opening on demand, is assured by the two bottom relays. But also, we don't have a picture here, but also when you are closing, if one relay is not working, you can reach a safety function anyway. And you can have also possibility of bipolar isolation with the load for the operator safety. So you can isolate it in bipolar for, of course, for high voltage loads. And but we have also another concept here to we want to introduce is the safety and the availability. So relay is safe when a fault in the relay is not sufficient to create a dangerous condition. While the availability, the fault is not sufficient to activate a spurious trip of the load. So the availability means I don't, my system is not stopping because I have one single relay fault. And that's important because you are in a safety condition, you don't want to stop your plant, but if you are having an hardware problem, generic, you can stop your plant, you can stop your production. That is a really unwanted situation. While the safety is different, of course, so you want to close or you want to open on demand. In this case, you are not able because your system is in failure condition. So in both cases, this kind of relays offer higher safety and also high availability. Okay, Massimo, it's your part. This is...
No, it's your.
Still mine. Yeah. Okay, fine. Pass testing. We have also introduced the line monitoring pass testing, which is generated by common DCS or PLCs. I think you are aware about that. So what is, the pass testing is doing? Pass testing is generating to verify the integrity of the load in both energized or de-energized state. And are connected with the load. So basically, if you don't use a relay, the load is continuously tested. this can create some, say, of course, can shorten the life of the load because it can have some flickering on your load, and maybe you can, after a period, you can destroy your system. But basically, when you are connected to our safety relays, this testing is limited to the relay, so it will be stopped by the relay coil. And the relays, smart relays, are of course designed to be, say, compatible with this pass test. It means that this pass test will not activate the coil, will not activate the load continuously. So it will be protected from any, say, spurious or continuous activation that maybe can destroy the short life of the relays. This is important also when you are using safety relay beside ours, of course. So you have to pay attention that that safety relay must be compatible with the pass testing from the PLC. That it can be used, it can be also available for normal energized and normal de-energized load. And sometimes on this system cannot be excluded. It means that you will be can stay there for continuously and cannot be excluded in case you don't want to use it, as in this case. Okay.
Okay, let's see specifically how the smart relay can communicate with the system. How and what are the ways in which a smart relay can communicate with the safety system? Smart relay can report the field status to the system in several ways. The first one is the two fault contacts can be acquired by a digital input card. This is the typical way, which implies the use of DCS with a dedicated digital input card, where the status of a contact called a fault is monitored by the system. The second method, if the system digital output card driving the smart relay support path testing, the fault in the field can even be mirrored directly to the digital output without the need of an additional digital input card. And again, complete diagnostic information can be retrieved through Modbus Multidrop RS485 protocol if a Modbus master is available on the system side. Remember that through the Modbus protocol, the smart relay can be constantly monitored and also configured remotely. And again, the fault on bus can also be acquired by a system digital input card. The fault on bus is normally used when a cumulative report from many modules is required. Well, Andrea, is your turn.
Okay, so safety relays, for the full diagnostic, we are talking about a serial relay with the truth certification. Those are the relays available for 5096S, 5096-100, 5294 for fine gas application for normally energized high availability. The other two are available for fine gas application, normally energized high availability phase inversion. What kind of features we can offer? We can offer voltage and internal diagnostic for voltage and current on load, load resistance that is patented, leakage from the load to heart, coil integrity, internal faults. It means internal faults when one of the four relays is failing, okay? We can get this alert on our relays. And also the Modbus LTO 485 is supported. Not on all of that, but there are relays with the Modbus and relay without. And other features, of course, there are two fault relays, two contacts. The fault is available also over the bus and also the same Modbus. We say that these are compatible with the DO card line monitoring pass test. Also, there is a possibility to have, and we have tested with the different systems, the fault mirroring to the DO card. So it means that the DO card can get the information or can detect there is a fault on the, that is the transmitted over the relays. So over the same two wire that is going to the relay coil, I can detect that there is a fault on my system. That is very important because you can reduce in this case the use of external fault contact, Modbus or whatever. Contact rating for amp 250 VAC. Installation for zone 2, DIR 2. Relays are also offering universal mounting, DIN rail and power bus and the termination boards for the DCS. And it is complete input output power supply isolation. Here we have a table where we can, the most important relays are here, and where you can have an overview about the functionalities. So you see that those four relays are the most, sold in our catalog, are certified for both for non-energized and normal energized load. They have monitoring functionalities that are, of course, more completed in the last two, 5294S and the 5295S. And the last two also offering the Modbus interface. Now we see really the application for fire and gas, and the MEM probably is now your turn, Massimo.
Yes, okay, Andrea, thank you for your explanation. And now let's introduce the specific topic of today. Typically in today's process industry, there are different types of applications. Of course, one of the most important is certainly the fire and gas system. But what is a fire and gas system, and what are the tools that the GMI offers to meet the needs of this type of application? Well, a fire and gas safety system continuously monitors for abnormal situations such as a fire or a combustible or toxic gas release within the plant, and provides early warning and mitigation action to prevent escalation of the incident and protect the process or environment. In most cases, a fire and gas system involves the activation of a load, such as the deluge valve, alarm signaling tools, such as bells, sounder, and beacons, ventilation system, and so on. Of course, the brain and the controller of the system is the safety PLC, but to make a plant or the entire industrial process safe, it must use intelligent tools such as smart relays. Because they are called smart relays, because this relay allows the PLC to extend its diagnostic capabilities up to the final load, which in the fire and gas system is that element that is activated to protect the system or to give the alarm signal. And why it's important in a fire and gas system to always be in control and always know what is the state of health of the system? Well, the answer is what would happen if at the beginning of the fire and gas system is not available due to its own failure to intervene to mitigate the damage. We would have disastrous consequences. But let's see how a smart relay can help us and how it works in a fire and gas application. First of all, we can say that internally, a GMI smart relay is composed of a matrix of contacts, which allow us to have high reliability and high availability to the process. This safety relay is in fact SIL-free certified, both for application with normally de-energized loads, our fire and gas system to be clear, and for application with normally energized loads. ESD type application, which we'll see later in this presentation. But let's see in specifically. The load applied to the relay, in this case, a beacon, is off in normal condition and the relay contacts are open. When at the request of the safety PLC, the load must intervene to signal the dangerous event. The relay close its contact, through them it supplies power to the beacon, which gives the alarm signal. A typically fire and gas application involving GMI's D5294S smart relay in the following. The D5294S monitors the line, the power supply, and the load, in this case a sounder, under normal condition when switched off. By doing so, it ensures that if requested by the PLC, the loop will work correctly. This type of relay can be configured via software or via Modbus for specific diagnostic value. When switched off, it's able to monitor the impedance of the load, the power supply to the load, and is able to auto-check the coil of its internal electromechanical relay. It's also able to provide two fault contacts towards a DCS system dedicated to the purpose, or it has the possibility of mirroring any fault detected in the field directly on the diagnosed PLC card. This function, called fault mirroring, is compatible with different types of digital output cards of the most common PLC system and allows considerable saving in terms of engineering cost, as it allows the not use of a DCS system dedicated to the acquisition of a fault. Let's see how it works. The relay monitors the loop, and if it detects a malfunction of the load or its power supply, it immediately reports it to the PLC through the mirroring function or to a dedicated DCS system by closing two fault contacts. This is called predictive diagnostics, fundamental in fire and gas system to ensure that the loop will work when there is a real need. The smart relay, in this case, through its diagnostic function, allows the PLC system to extend its loop monitoring capability up to the load. For this reason, and many other, the smart relay is a fundamental tool in a fire and gas loop. Furthermore, this type of relay can communicate and can be programmed via Modbus, with all the advantages that this communication protocol can give. In the next slide, we introduce what is the relay programming software, which allows us to have total control over the functional parameters of the load and the voltage applied to it. As previously said, in condition of relay off, it can monitor the impedance of the load, the power supply voltage of the leader, and the health of the internal electromechanical relay. This relay also allows us to set the window of values within which the diagnosed variable must fall in order not to generate a fault. In fact, for example, we can set a minimum and maximum value for the load power supply, outside of which the relay will signal an anomaly to the system. The typical example may be that represented by the short circuit on our load caused by a malfunction of the winding inside the beacon. The relay, by monitoring the impedance of the beacon input circuits, will read an anomalous value outside the window of values considered valid during the relay programming, and will signal a fault to the system. This fault signal will occur through the closure of two fault contacts to be acquired through a dedicated DCS system. A red light will light up on the front of the relay. Through the programming software, it's also possible to monitor in real time what happens in the loop. Any fault will be underlined by a red indication and will warn us that the monitor values have gone out of normal operation activity. The D5294S is also able to monitor any leakage between the load and earth. This particular feature is part of the predictive diagnostic perspective for a fire and gas system. This data provides us with particular information on the earth of the load, informing us if a possible earth leakage can be harmful to our application. Also in this case, the configuration software provides us with important information on the state of all health of the load, monitoring the impedance value that the load has towards the ground. In case of a fault detected, the relay communicates the fault occurred to the system to allow us to act promptly on the problem and solve it. Some old PLC system work with inverted logic, over supply energization to the relay. For this reason, we need a relay that reverses the safety function of the system to bring our fire and gas system to safety. Also in this case, the GMI smart relay helps us by giving complete diagnostic coverage to the loop and helping the PLC to reverse the safety function. In this case, the D5295S model maintains the functions of the model presented previously and changed, but give us the possibility of inverting the safety function using normally closed contacts. In fact, under normal operating condition, the load will be normally energized. Therefore, for a fire and gas load, the PLC system must have a normally energized logic so that the relay can reverse the function on the load. In this way, the relay contacts will be open during normal loop activity. At the request of the PLC, the relay will be de-energized and the contacts will close energizing the load, which will provide the alarm signal. Also for this type of relay, thanks to the contact matrix technique, we will obtain high process availability and high level of safety, still free certified. Also for this smart relay, the diagnostic function remains unchanged. In fact, with a view to a predictive diagnostic, we will be able to monitor the state of the load and its supply voltage. When the relay is energized, that is when its contacts are open and consequently the load de-energized. In this way, we'll be able to monitor the impedance value of the load to verify its state of health over time. In case of anomalous variation of the load input circuit, the relay will signal the change to the safety system, declaring a fault. Fault which, as we have seen previously, can be signaled in different ways, through the mirroring function, through the full contracts to be dedicated to a specific acquisition system, or even through Modbus. The types of relay seen up to now for fire and gas application are also widely used for emergency shutdown application. In fact, thanks to the contract batteries, these relay are able to perform a certified seal-free safety level and die process availability even for this type of application. But how does a relay work in an emergency shutdown application? Well, the relay in this case is that device which, at the request of the safety PLC or DCS, must ensure the de-energization of its load and bring it to a safe state. Typically, we are talking about a shutdown valve which must interrupt the flow of the dangerous fluid to bring the system to safety. In this case, we are talking about an application that involves a typically energized relay, which in turn works in normal condition with its contact closed and energizes the shutdown valve, which in turn allows the passage of dangerous fluid. Also in this case, the use of a smart relay is important to monitor the health of the valve. It's necessary to know in advance any problem that could arise in the event of a request from the safety system if the valve should have any problem. The smart relay guarantees complete diagnostic of the load and of the line associated with it, even in the condition of energized relay. In this condition, the smart relay constantly monitors the power supply voltage of the valve and the current that circulates in the coil of the relay. In this way, it's possible to monitor every slightest variation in the state of the relay load loop. And also in this case, the smart relay helps and extend the diagnostic capability of the safety system. As previously mentioned, even for normally energized load, thanks to the contract metrics, the D5294 smart relay provides high availability to the process. In fact, the failure of one of the contract inside the metric is not sufficient to generate a malfunction of the relay, which maintains its functions unchanged also for this eventuality. Even for this type of application, the configuration software signals any load malfunction by reading the variables related to the load itself. The signaling takes place on the monitor, underlining the cause of the fault in red or with the types of communication seen previously. Another particular application involving smart relay with a normally energized load is that relating to valves with dual coils. In this specific case, since each coil is sufficient to activate the valve, the two coils avoid false interpretation in the event of a single coil opening, thus increasing availability. In this context, the D5294S can detect the opening of the single valve coil. Through the configured software and by specifically setting the diagnostic value of the current flow in the two coils, it's possible for the smart relay to detect if one of the two coils is interrupted. In fact, if one of the two coils is interrupted, the current circulating the loop is halved and the value read by the relay leaves the window of the value, set value, signaling a fault. Fault that also in this case can be signaled to the safety system in different way. One of these is the mirroring of the fault, which communicate the problem with the load directly to the digital output of the safety system. Through a variation in the impedance of the input circuit of the smart relay. This functionality has been tested with some of the most popular safety PLCs on the market and found to be fully compatible. Well, Andrea, I leave you time for some words on Modbus and the compatibility with our devices.
We have another poll.
Okay.
You wanna hope you're still alive after this all these technical things. Hope it was explained well. I think it was we had some pictures for explanation. If you were not of course sufficient, just contact us later and we can give you more details. Of course, those are mainly, it's a extracted from our application notes we did during the years with different systems. So also for the ones you asked before, you just please stay in touch with us if you are using specific DCS, PLCs, whatever, or specific field device. We can give you some information. We can also say give you details of what you have to use, maybe to use some resistance or to something, or maybe a special configuration for the relays that support the Modbus configuration in order to detect a fault and so on. Okay, thank you very much. I hope we can add a few seconds if you want to answer. Still people alive. What feature for safety relays is most relevant? I see that we have ex-aequo answer. Okay, we can stop. We can show you ex-aequo is alarm contact out of the old mirroring on system DO. Okay, that's very important. Modbus out, configurable threshold, and pass test compatibility. Okay, we can go on. We can go, let's say, at the end, about Modbus interface. It's not, I see that it's not very relevant for you, but we want to give you more details. Modbus is very common in, it's, let's say, slow protocol for communication, for detecting, for, and we can connect our relay support this kind of, few relays support this kind of protocols. It can be introduced in a network where there are up to 127 modules in a multi-drop. So by a single Modbus master port, by two wires, you can detect, you can read the parameters of the relays that are connecting in this network. And, but the benefit we see is that one Modbus interface for all connected relays, multi-drop connection communication up to 1,200 meters. You don't need a, if you use this kind of detection, you don't need to use the digital input card for detecting the failure. And important things also that through the Modbus, you can get a specific resistors dedicated for each single fault that may happen on your system. So short information for short circuit is different from the information for open circuit. So you can have a specific information about that. While through the contact, you can get just a generic information on the fault. So there are some advantages. And, we finished the things. Huh? But I see that there are some, before going to the conclusion, maybe you can answer to the people. What are the max environment temperature you can have? Well, the relays can stand up to 70 degrees Celsius, maximum.
Yes, the temperature rating is minus 40 degrees plus 70 degrees.
Mm. That is environment temperature.
Yeah.
And of course, the higher temperature, the lower, say, or the shorter lifetime for the device. But basically, we can say that 70 degrees is a very good is limit. Also, we have relays that have been installed in few in the desert in an application really high, at high temperature, and that they can we have experience on that kind of application. And inside the cabinet, it's very, very hot, and then battery relay can stand also in that case. Yes, Modbus, other question. Yes, Modbus, interesting, said Modbus. Oh, yes, Modbus. Is a part of is Modbus, sorry. Is Modbus part of the CL loop? Question. No, because the certification is only for the safety coil to load is a CL3.
For the diagnostic, but Modbus is not considered CL.
The diagnostic, it means that the fault relay, fault out, are considering to the CL, but the Modbus not. Okay, so conclusion. We have some conclusion here, and this is also, I think, is very important because it's given excursus of what we did with our relays. For the main manufacturer system like Schneider Electric, Yokogawa, Honeywell, Emerson, ABB, HEMA, Rockwell. So we tested and approved with different Schneider Electric system, like Tricon, Tricon CX, Foxborn. We are doing this kind of testing with the Modicom. We did testing with the ProSafe and Centum VP for the Yokogawa system. Of course, we did a testing with the safety manager. And we did a test with the Emerson, Delta V, Delta V SIS, with the ABB SIS 800, we tested with the HEMA, IMAX we tested, and also with the Rockwell Advance. Some of them are tested, approved by the manufacturer, some of them just tested, but sufficient for us for giving information about the compatibility, especially compatibility we are talking about the OCR compatibility, we are talking about mirroring for the relays, for the fault, that is also very important. There is one question. Many times we observed that between two relays or barriers, burning was observed and no cold air circulated between two systems. Is there any arrangement of smart relays for cold air circulation? What we can say, Massimo, about installation for the relay? We can install in a horizontal or vertical position, okay? Horizontal, vertical.
For the D5000 series, it's not important. Both arrangement of installation is correct. But in some cases where the temperature is very high inside the cabinet, our advice is to distanciate, to put between the two devices at most one centimeter of distance to allow the device.
Air circulation. Okay, yeah. 1 centimeter. In case you are, it's very hot situation, probably the environment side is very hot, plus the unit that are eating inside the cabinet, maybe a few millimeter, 1 centimeter for air circulation will be enough.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
Try to summarize what we have discussed in today's presentation.
Yeah.
Okay, and why it's important to you. First of all, the universal solution, which allow us to extend the limits of the system digital output card for the compatibility of the loads applied to it and in all conditions.
Okay, we have seen that diagnostic information available for open short circuit, power supply fault, ground leakage, load resistance variation, relay failure. I want just to tell you that not all of them are okay. We have already seen there is you have to choose what kind of diagnostic label you want to have, because there are some limitations on some relays, but basically those are the diagnostic information you may have from the relays.
Yeah. And again, we see high process availability and full tolerance for the prevention of spurious trips with the contact method GMI's Marilli, which allow more resilient solution that prevent the system from downtime.
Certification, CL3 certification with a lifetime of 20 years. So, and I want to tell you another thing, CL3, of course you can use also the relay in the CL2 application. In this case, that is very important. The testing proof for the relay, for the hardware, can be increased a lot. If you are talking, if we have a CL3 for 3 years, probably you have a CL2 for 12 years. It is very important. But also we have 20 years lifetime.
Yeah. The transparency of the field fault through the mirroring functionality of the our barriers or smart relays allows significant savings in terms of installation and wiring cost.
Cost reduction. We have seen that if you can get the mirroring functionality of your system, you don't use a digital input card for fault acquisition. You reduce the hardware wiring and simplify the engineering.
Yes, a great flexibility with the GMI solution, which allows you to manage all types of loads and field conditions in small spaces.
Modbus interface monitoring the load and fault condition. It's give you much more information for troubleshooting and continuous data acquisition.
And the possibility with our relays to manage types of loads connected both in unipolar or bipolar way, guaranteeing field diagnostics where required. This solution allows great saving in terms of installation cost.
We have we did a lot of interoperability test certification, reference and so on our relay. So we can, if you have any specific card we are using with, we can be of your help, of course. Okay, we finish. We remind you that our live webinar schedule, you can find next webinars for, let's say this is, should be the last one. And then we start again in September, we probably new topics. Thank you for answering this. This is very important for improving our presence and the communications to our attendees, to our people. If it was relevant for you, thank you. If it was not, you can answer as you like, as is a completely anonymous. So any suggestion is really, really, really appreciated from our side. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you again. And thank you so much. For no one is poor or not with the like expectation. Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm going to stop you. Thank you for, if you want to write something again, otherwise we stop now. Thank you. And we do have probably one last question. Thank you very much. Okay, that's fine. Thank you. And we can stop here. And we remind you that, of course, also this webinar and other webinars are available on our YouTube channel. You can have a look again, share with your colleague that did not attend or whatever is. We have a lot of webinar registered on our YouTube channel. We remind you our company name, our emails, name and face, so you can answer and you can write us whenever you like. Thank you. Thank you again for your participation.
And thank you,
Massimo. And keep in touch for other things.
Yes, bye-bye. And you have a good summer. Bye-bye.
Yeah, also from my side. Bye-bye.